Ben Nielsen. I'm a civil engineer with McLaughlin Whitewater Design Group in Denver, Colorado. I'm here at the Snake River, the famed lunch counter wave, to do some research and development into a really emerging market in river sports, river surfing. And one of the things that we want to do at McLaughlin Whitewater is harness a lot of the things that make this wave great into man-made features. The wave itself is unique for a lot of reasons. I think that probably to me the most unique thing about it is just the performance. People are out here riding on literally short boards that professional surfers are riding in some of the best waves in the world. You can ride them here on the river. To surf the lunch counter wave, first you have to ferry across the river. So there's a lot of current in this location, so you basically have to go upstream, paddle across, and catch eddy surfs on the other side. From there, you get out, get up on the rocks, and you actually jump off the rocks onto kind of a little mini wave, kind of a seam that basically conveyor belts you over to the main feature. You know, once you're on there, it's high performance. You can do bottom turns off the tops. I've seen guys do airs here. It's really amazing to see these guys that have been out here logging a lot of river time. The bottom that creates different hydraulics. You can make a really fantastic freestyle rodeo hole, real sticky, lots of pile, and you know, and 5 minutes later make more of a green wave that's really great for surfing. This is a technology that has been tried to be imitated by other engineers, but we're the first to develop it. We really feel that it's a really great technology. It's going to allow places that don't have a lot of volume of flow to create world-class whitewater.